G'day and welcome to my garage. There we go, there's the slot in the other frame, the second frame. The foot needs repositioning. The original position is up here. I need to bring it in so I stay within the turning radius of my little mini lathe. Must think about getting some transfer punches one day. But this works. This should now put the foot inside the, well it is, it will be inside the envelope, so I can now re-machine these three surfaces here parallel with the inside face. This is the back frame. And everything works off this face. That's the worm carrier. Well, the worm carrier, and the worm carrier then sets the position of the worm wheel. There's a marriage going on there, obviously. But it all works off this face, as the other inside face is a bit hard to machine. I've got three legs in the way. So I've machined this once before on the milling machine, but I'm now going to do it again because I wanted to move this leg back, or foot, to get it inside the turning radius of my lathe. Originally this casting was left rough and then those three surfaces machined. Now, because I've moved it, I need this plane to be in the same position as when, in the same plane as when it was in this forward position or outer position. So that's dropped this foot down by a few thou, but about 10-15 thou. So now that it's been machined, I have to re-machine these pads. So that's the next order of operation. I'll see you on the lathe. I'm just going to finish cleaning the end of that off. That's the foot. Yeah. Yep, that's good now. And now I'll face off the foot and the base there. Very nice finish. That's a lot better. I can deburr that now, turn it around, and oh no, I have to machine the hub off. Better do that before I forget. Okay, the hub is also done now. This is the front frame, and what I'm going to do is face off these spreaders, and what I've done here is I've put some fairly large, these are 45mm approximately, spacers, furniture, whatever you want to call them. Two bolts are holding the whole thing together. I like to use a big one because it offers a lot of support to the plate. So let's face off these spreaders. Don't take too much off. Gingery doesn't give a size for these except for what the size of the leg is, spreader is in the pattern. The important thing is this is the casting for the worm, so it has to fit between the two plates. Presently this is the pattern. Presently the legs are shorter than that, but I can face off a bit of that and a bit of that side to fit it in between. So let's crank it up and smooth off these, level out these legs. 15. Bring it back to 20. Just use a power feed. Okay, that one's good, that one's good, and that one's good. So they're all nice and even. I will now remount this plate the other way around to machine off the centre boss. I'll catch you then. And now for this boss. And that turned out good. There's a pinhole in there, bit of a casting defect. It's just a casting made. thought I was going to be smart. Oil gallery. No, it's not. It's just a casting defect. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter the surface. That's good. So, where's the other piece? What do I do with the other frame? I might just clean up this. No, I'll leave it. The other. No, I better do it because the other side's done. This doesn't need to be done. I'm just making it the same as the other side. The other side was machined because it had the foot. Excuse me. So I'm just making it all equal. Take another. Yeah, 10 thou.
More to go, another 10.
That's a good pass. Nice and clean. Yep. That'll do for that. The front and back plate are held together at that prescribed distance by bolts coming through into the support leg, the spreader leg. So, and to be able to get them in the right place, we need to drill up from the bottom through there. And the interesting part will be is that I've only got about 3/16, a quarter. I've got about a quarter of the shank of a 5mm drill to hold on with. So let's see how we go. So it's got the hub and the leg, and they're not level, unfortunately. So this is the hardware I made up for other spacing jobs on this job. So we're going to bolt this to the table. Rotates, so that won't be a problem. Put this roughly in the right place. Get in from underneath. Come on. Right. I've already drilled one hole. I'll show you this hole, and then, yeah, you know the game. Drill jammed. And that's through. That's two holes, one more to go.